Welcome everyone, this is New-NAW Voltage number 17. I am Al Cabrera. I am the commentator for this huge card, three big matches for tonight. We're going to start off with the Eon Hardcore title. No one will have this, it's not the Eon Hardcore title. Despite which my commentary partner will not say in the future. This Bonkers, he's going to be defending it with that work down here tonight. Big implications coming out of page 40. As we saw two of the champions get challengers from chapter 11. Lemarcus Carter is going to be defending against El Noveno. After winning the battle royal, unfortunately I was in it, but I still look forward to hopefully challenging for the Mountain Ridge title for Mir Hell's trip to see sports guys over the trip. He lost along with the followers of Helenus and the Wolf tag match in that page. And against Mason Kronik, who will be in action when he comes in as a contender for the West Coast team, which is held by Will Meg. He's going to be taking on his brother, Aaron Omega, making his first appearance here and now since he debuted in the Destiny Rumble back in Chapter 10, starting at number 1 and lasting a very long time to level. Later, his partner and his nickname defeated him on page 39. He was also in that battle royal. He did not win. Sports guy is a multi-time hardcore champion, trying to get the tag division as well. And of course, this man fought with Dark Carnival, the new version of the Dark Carnival. Bonkers, his current champion, he defeated Larry, actually, the most recent episode of Vintage. He defeated Eric, become the champion, kind of an upset there. He's got huge pieces to the ladder. And he is now defending it the first time he was a sports guy. There's the current Western Tag Team Champion, the other members, Shane Corson and Puma of the Dark Carnival. All members of the Dark Carnival are holding championship gold at the moment. Of course, we had other members of Fortune that were attacked. Supposedly by Bill, they have no longer been on, they are released. So we have a new version of Duffy here as Mother's Voltage. Now, the sports guy, looks like, did not want to wait, and they would block. Mother blocks that, tosses it into the back. See this new shiny Voltage Arena that we've acquired the last few times, as you can see, and that simply kind of cool. So this is both kind of hardcore rules, anything goes, any weapons are allowed. If tonight and anyone can challenge for the title, it's 27. Because I'm confident. I am performing multi-time hardcore champion as well. That's how I broke into now. Is winning that hardcore title. So people will see that they're going to joke. If there's a huge tennis shot by the final. But it can actually propel to other opportunities, and oh, what a title, she used the belt, smack sports guy around the face with it. Other opportunities for certain to move up the card, this headshot, she's trying to move up the card, I'm a former champion. So it can do well for it, of course, it does for all companies that can be true for the universe. Eon, PW Wave Force, OPW, of course, we know and Empire. I'm going to be a wrestler. Sports guy was. Gets one of the top rope and gets clapped in the face. Where's the candlestick by Bonkers? So, this is the hardcore match. We have had a lot of hardcore a little bit more. Of course, I had that title change hands multiple times. Of course, a few pages ago, it was change hands like 8 or 10 times. We can't tell. Steel step shot right to the face. Cover it one, two. Only two can hold there. And then Bonkers holding on to the title. The sports guy, as I said, he's had a couple losses in that tag division. This could be a big bounce back if he can win this championship. Bounces off the table. This sports guy. Sports guy goes Bonkers. I hold eyes. This is the least. like a big chunk of it. Bounces off the ring or something. Sports ball is gonna take a turn here. And a chair shot with a scalp. Big chair shot with big implications. Going into the last page. Just saw the BCW of hydraulic. Oh, on that show. That's gonna be cool. I'm sorry, but you have candle ink on that show. And then on the next page, which section is gonna be one on one with Andrew Leon. So that should be a good match right there. With suplex on Bonkers. Back out. Where is DDT? Bonkers goes back in the ring. He's got that steel chair. Puts it in the corner. Need to do something here. Oh, another weapon. So this new version of the dog carnivore is good to be effective. Baseball bat. Oh, that blocks it. Clock into the chest with it. And on page 29, where it became the tag team champion, beating the puppy. Elbow right here to face out, plus we're on the road to chapter 11. Two matches, four title matches. Oh! Right into that chair. To the face, and then sports guy up to the top. Flying headbutt. Into the cover. Cover, one, two. So close, only two right now. And there's one of the matches that's confirmed. We can also confirm for you. Evan actually is going to be defending the Central Zone Championship. I'm not sure against who just yet. That's going to happen. As well. And there will be a match at Chapter 11 to determine the number of contenders for the East Coast title final chapter. That's a big dive, 2 count. Because I missed a dive, and I was paying attention for that. As you know, I am competing myself in professions. Either way, that goes into the guardrail right there. The lettuce is a sports guy. I had that huge dive, but only got a 2 count. On Bonkers. On Bonkers with the ladder. This is what helped him become the hardcore champion when he beat Lariat. Electric chair drop. Bonkers into the cover. Two, only 2 count. That big Euro 90 right there. No chair shot right to the head. I can feel good. Tosses him all the way over there. Goes for the elbow, but oh, sports guy blocks it. Sports guy runs up the stairs. But they will take advantage and hit that stun gun right there. No way, gutbuster. Big time gutbuster right there. There's the brick though, and Packers look out for about onto the ladder, his leg and his chest caving into that ladder. This is what helped him to allow him to become the hardcore champion. And this also sends a suplex into this hilarious onto the ladder. Sports guy might not be kind of the last thing in this match. So moonsault knees up. Sports guy able to take advantage with the moonsault. Stopping the moonsault with the knees. That should make sweet. Might have got the ladder there. Trying to take advantage of that mistake. by Bonkers back suplex. Big back suplex. What a switch right in here. Push up, close it out. Close by. Code Red onto the ladder. Code Red onto the ladder. Hooks the leg. Two and three. Sky. That sports guy becomes the new Eon Hardcore Champion, just like that. What a match that is to start off his focus. He is set to start right there by Bonkers. When the first cover of the match, this was pretty brutal, falling all over the arena. A big headbutt. This is after he got tossed into the steel chair that was in the corner. That was only the 2 times. And sports guy dives. That's what I just realized I was talking about. Greatest thing that happened in the next page. But he hit that dive. That was over the 2 count. And we had this year at 90. For champions here. And then finally the Code Red onto the ladder. Back and spawning first. Play it with Bonkers was not going to get up from that. Punched out of there together. And he, that's it. And Sports Guy becomes Hardcore Champion just like that. But who knows the umpteenth time he's been Hardcore Champion. But wait, R-Truth is here. He just kicked Sports Guy in the face. Roll up. Two. And R-Truth just won the Hardcore title. From Sports Guy. From that Sports Guy. What in the world is going on? R-Truth is here. Just won the Hardcore title. Goodbye. Over the top rope. Now Truth's got the championship and he's running off. He's gone. Strong words from the number one contender to the East Coast Championship. Speaking of the East Coast Championship, here is the East Coast Champion, Lemarcus Carter. Out of his match here tonight, he's going to go one-on-one with Mike Valander. Like I said, the number one contender is El Arena, and he will challenge the East Coast Champion. But we need to decide who is going to be the number one contender for either of the rest of the school titles, depending on who Norm chooses. And there's going to be a match tournament now, the final chapter of that. Chapter 11. We will hear soon on that decision. We know Joe Omega has been pushing him to pick the West Coast title. But Joe might not even be champion if he loses to Mr. Kronik. But a lot of things going on this year. So Carter is here. Going to be in action right now against that Valander. He defeated Flip Flower on the last voltage. That Brendan had mentioned that on page 4. Valander looking to get in the title hunt. Big win could do that for him. If he's able to get a victory. Also, I can confirm to you that I was told by the New-NAW board of directors that I will be getting a one-on-one Mountain Rage title shot against Amir Barnes on page 4. That is also confirmed. Me versus Amir Barnes for the Mountain Rage title one-on-one. There is also confirmation that there will be a match for the Mountain Rage title. Right now it's scheduled to be a triple threat between Amir Danny and Bill Reyes. But both me and Larry are trying to competition I wanted to watch, and if I was to win the title, that would force me into that match anyway. So we'll see what happens with that. We're also going to have, apparently, even though Punk has just lost the hardcore title, we've been their opportunity, Evan O'Shea is going to defend the Central Zone title against Bonkers on Patreon. Big matches, all being confirmed to you by yours truly, our Cabrera, for page 41. And here we go. Match starts up here, Mike Valander versus Lemarcus Carter, 101 hits. Big warm-up match against Carter. A big uppercut by Mike, started right away with the uppercut. East Coast champion, a confident East Coast champion, who hasn't had to wrestle as much in the past few weeks. He did wrestle on a vulture a few weeks ago against Suspect. We know the whole story with that was Suspect. He attacked him. Josh Bishop pointing the blame towards Dark Carnival. Matt, I think Benjamin's concerned him. Joshua Bishop arranged a false coming match on the last page, which Matt, I think, should force him. So there's a whole idea for the tag titles. It's scheduled to be a rematch, Pup Pup versus Dark Carnival. But I've been told that Bishop is petitioning to add him and Icon to the match, so that couldn't be happening very soon. It's my big uppercut in this match. So, as a competitor, but also as an informationist for you, in this way, the fans, I'm here to tell you about what's going on in the future. Mike, in control right now of the East Coast champion, looking for pump handle. It was countered into a back suplex by Lemarcus Carter. So, Lemarcus Carter has been the champion for a reason. Defeating Dorn at Chapter 8 to become the East Coast champion. Been unsuccessfully defending at Chapter 9 against Matt Icon. Took the 10 minutes. He won it at Chapter 9. After Matt Icon won the Festival World Tournament, you know Joshua Bishop has been pushing Icon to be more mean, more aggressive. And that's why he didn't win the championship. So that could be possible. Like I said, Mike Valander, he himself, he's trying to get back to the championship. He returned after a short absence when he had been in that triple threat match up to the championship. And he was the one that took the pin after I was supposed to win the championship. So he's looking to get back on the track himself. Like wrenching down on the neck of Lemarcus Carter. Big matches for the team. Speaking of Joshua Bishop, big implication to be is that even though the public will get the rematch, Bishop has been petitioning for the rematch, and we're gonna get a match. It's gonna be Joshua Bishop versus Tasmanian Tournament, also on page 41. And if Bishop wins, then there has to be a big opportunity for him to be, for him and Mike, for him to be added to the match. As we saw, Big DDT, Mike Valander, is looking for a military press, and Carter blocked it. Carter looking for a big shot on the hunting knife. Mike stunned on the apron right there. The Carter is able to take down a veteran opportunity. Big opportunity in this second. Marcus Carter held championship in the universe. He's the current Empire US champion as well. Big driver. He held that Phantom Beast Buster by Mike Valander. I'm not sure it's going to be happening. I went for that again. He got a DDT on the floor. Carter could take the count on it, but he's choosing not to. He also had the recent multiple DDT, the recent emergence of NAW Europe territory run by NAW superstar TJ Nicholson behind the scenes of a big neck breaker. Be a new venture that NAW is seeking. going to be a big opportunity there down the line. Female superstar is going to be a part of that in the future. Hellenist, as well as Empire's Tom Walker, will be a part of that. We'll share more details in the future. And there's the Flattener by Mike Valander. Let's focus on the matchup. But Flattener to... Oh, Carter kicks out. I don't know how Carter kicked out of that. Valander's been pretty impressive in this match. And so is Carter with their Carter. This thing is even better. Can't get a bit of that easily. Big DDT right there. Spine Buster onto Mike Valander. Two, only a two count. For the next night, but we'll get that out of the way. Atomic drop. That stuns Mike to send him out of the ring. Carter's gonna follow him. Goes into the barricade. Hard into the barricade again. Now a big suplex by Carter. Pages, hydraulic coming. The fourth final chapter. Two more pages, I believe. So more voltages. Chapter 11, excuse me. Now we will be close to the road to final chapter. Potential lag. Is it a dodge lag? The big implications. Was one of the commentators that will be a part of NAW, since said Brendan will be commentating, and of course I will be a part as well. The others will join Hurricane Rana there. Mike got caught with the Hurricane Rana. Looking to expand NAW, make it as best as it can be, as well as the umbrella companies that NAW was associated with, such as Force, GWA, OPW, and all of those. We don't go to this. Look out, cradle driver there. Carter was able to take advantage of that Hurricanrana and keep control of Mike Valander. Mike has been heads up in himself for the last couple minutes since then. Carter's gonna end it with the Moneymaker. Moneymaker to Mike Valander. Hooks the leg. One, two, and three. Carter, big win. Big momentum heading into his championship match going into Chapter 11. We know there will be a confrontation between the two that's going to happen in the middle of the ring on the next page as well. A lot to look forward to in the next coming weeks. We are also going to confirm to you the Fantasy Division is coming to NAW. As you see that big spine buster. Fantasy Division will happen, and the first match, the first round, is going to happen on the next page as well. It's going to be Snake, Solid Snake versus Ash Williams. That match is also big matches already confirmed for the next page. And that tournament is going to be happening throughout the coming weeks of NAW to crown the first ever Legacy Champion. As Carter celebrates his win, we saw that big money maker to finish him off. Able to turn around after Mike dominated for the middle part of that matchup. You know, like I said, we heard Elevino earlier talking about his opportunity to face this one. And now here we are, our main event. So Elevino is confident for his match. Carter, a big win. And our main event here tonight of New-NAW Voltage 17. Mason Kronik is going to be 1-on-1, number one contender for the Costco title. Right? So 1-on-1 with Aaron Omega is expected to be accompanied by Joe. This should be interesting. You know, Mason Kronik had a little bit of a rough patch a few weeks ago, you know, losing a couple of matches, plus a 6-point challenge leading up to the Elimination Chamber match, which Joe Omega won the West Coast title. Kronik was pinned. First man to be pinned in that chamber match. but he did was able to bounce back in a last place and last voltage, I believe, when he defeated TJ Smith. Fires TJ Smith. That's a good relationship there. Between the two bands. OPW as well, DWA. New talent fluxing into the off. Big, big changes coming in now. Mason Kronik makes his way to the ring. Bandit isn't really concerned with winning matches the conventional way as much as hurting him. He's only going for a lot of covers versus just inflicting punishment on his opponent. And of course, Kronik is the number one contender. He's getting that shot for the West Coast title. That is the question. The question is, can he capture the championship? Joe's been a fighting champion. See, it's not really that just a bit realistic. Plus, stellar. I mean, he defeated Lariat at the Best in the World Tournament Special to retain his championship. He beat Ozzy Andy, beat TJ Nicholson in a 2 out of 3 falls match. Big matches, big title wins. Title victory. His Ad Omega, which was supposed to be a company, he was supposed to be combined with WWE, he's not here. Don't know why, don't. He was scheduled to be here to scout his challenger, and Joe is not here. His Ad Omega is going it alone here tonight. He's going one on one with him. And now there's, you know, some implications of him being TJ. TJ's throat right of with Joe after that big match. Aaron's in the fold now, so there's a good amount of confusion as to who's alone with whose side is TJ on. In the ring, and oh, he went for Aaron. Aaron moved, and the referee got clocked, but Aaron took him down for the third. So Aaron Omega, recently a part of Empire as well. A big feud with someone that's a big deal. Big close on there by Mason Kronik. Kronik looking for it. What's he doing here? Power bomb. Oh my god, into the apron right there. Brutal power bomb by Mason Kronik. But Kronik is not about winning the conventional way. He just said he's about punishing, hurting people, and getting results. That's all what Kronik's about. Sling Braid by Aaron. But I'd say Aaron Omega is a big athlete. Say any words at all. He's an impressive athlete. So I should say, look out. Phoenix Splash. Off the second rope there. Like I said, impressive athlete is Aaron Omega. Springboard Splash into the back. Trying to take advantage here. Looking for some type of DDT to pack. Big shot to the solar plexus. Not a shot right to the face. Can't teach a punch straight to the face. By Mason Kronik. Now another shot to the butt and on the tripping DDT. Kind of taking advantage of the situation here. Trying to rip into the bumper. What a slam right there. Few of the matches that are going to happen on the next page. Down the line, I can also tell you that future episode of Drop is going to happen. We're going to see how get another tag team matchup after the big win. Moonsault right there, cover one, two. I need two times. Apparently they got Empire Eastwood Connection, but they've been migrated into New-NAW as well. Of course, Isaiah Ice as well. When he had a big match against Warren Daly on the last page. Came up short though, but was able to prep. Look out, what a half suplex trap there on his head. So look out for the coming weeks. Going to the next page and in the stage card, which will be pretty soon. Elbows, right to the face of all of them, taking control. So not going for cover, trying to inflict damage, trying to wear down, touch to the hand. What big guy, big clover. That's Kronik, a big man, 200 something pounds, diving through the ropes. You don't see that very often. Kronik is not a small man, he just goes just like that. Looking for a powerbomb, but oh, using his agility to get out of it. No pinfalls on the outside, but he was able to escape whatever was going to happen. Springboard drop kick. Going to the winner, hit that springboard drop kick. And Aaron dragged. Kronik. Forced into the ring. Kronik is in the ring. Kronik will get out of the ring. Big knee right to the face. Good night. That might be a knockout shot by Kronik. Knee right to the face. There, Omega, no, another shot. And now, big spinning face buster there. Could be a better end for Aaron Omega, only a 2 count. Wow, look at Aaron. Aaron is getting twisted like a knot here. Version of close to a monkey wrench that with Andreas does. Switching out Aaron. Will he give up though? He either will shift his wings, gets a knee right to the head. Aaron. That big face buster right there. Good shots. Couple two shots to the legs to really take advantage of the situation. We can also confirm to you just that BW, like I said, they're having more prestige. Coming in July, there's going to be a prestige week. New-NAW will be a part of that event. It will be a part of that event. Look out, Boston Crab doesn't get anything from it. And instead, in the coming weeks, we will announce matches for that as well. One match I can confirm is the two champions right now. Joe Mega and Lemarcus Carter will go 1-on-1 in a champion versus champion matchup. That should be good. Work out. Big DDT, springboard off the ropes, DDT. What if Lettison from Aaron Omega? Maybe we could take advantage. Look out, face buster. Double chicken wing face buster. Into the cover. 1, 2. Only 2 like that, so they ended up. Was a part of the Destiny Rumble, had a good showing. Mr. Panther was also, he was number 27, but not as well. Aaron did get a few eliminations. Close on good, scrapes him, but look at the power. Able to still keep control here. Throws him up into the top 10 level. What is Kronik looking to do? He has the arm there, half and half, suplex off the top rope. Kronik just destroyed Aaron Omega with that half suplex off the top, and that can get him the victory. Oh, Aaron kicked now. How did Aaron kick out? I don't know. Like I said, look up Spine Buster. What a Scott High Spine Buster that was. Aaron did not recover from that half and half, and now the cross face. Will Aaron tap out? He's trying to get to the ropes. So he's bolted. New gets to the ropes. Lots more coming in the expansion of NAW. So now I might be a little rusty other than one of the commentary, but I'm all here. Small package, only the 2 count. Was trying to get a momentum, he was looking for something there, but Aaron hit caught with an elbow by Kronik. And another half and half right to the head. How many of those can Aaron take? Just got clocked with a half and half. Now look at another one, 2 in a row. 2 straight half and half suplexes. And a third to Aaron. I don't know how much more Aaron can take. I know Joe was supposed to be out here and be giving guidance to his brother, but I guess he didn't want to be face to face with Kronik. I would blame him. And I'm moved so by a giant man, but Aaron gets his knees up. I don't know if that hurts him as much as it hurt Kronik. And Aaron trying to take advantage and hits another sling blade. What the hell, but Kronik wisely. On the apron, I don't know how wide it is, I know he went for the clothesline, but Kronik saw it and jumped off the apron just in time. What a opportunity that was in a spinebuster. What a smart move by Mason Kronik, hitting that spinebuster. Literally dodged whatever Aaron was going for, and he just tosses him off the top rope. I don't know how much more Aaron has left after getting caught with that spinebuster. Seen him do this before. Looking at a big face buster. Gory bomb face buster. Just cracks Aaron on the face of Aaron. And I think Aaron's done. Kronik can just go for the cover because Aaron's not going to come. He is going to come, but I don't know if he even knows where he is because he's got locked. That cross face is locked in. Aaron. Where's he gonna go? Kronik has the crossface locked in. He's been trapped on his head multiple times. Trying to pull the dead 250 pound weight of Kronik, but I don't think he can anymore because he tapped. Kronik wins. What a victory for Mason Kronik. Momentum for him heading into his title match. We saw that face buster we thought was gonna could get the win after that springboard DDT. Kronik kicked out. A big spine bust, that was the first one that shook Aaron's spine. That took his crossface, but only with the different ropes. And another spine bust, this was like the three straight of those half and half suplexes. And there we go, we hear the words of Mason Kronik. He wants that championship. There's nowhere to hide. From Mason Kronik, Mason Kronik will be here for you tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining me. I am Al Cabrera. We'll see you on the next page. Big things happening in the expansion of NAW. Good to see you all next time.